Limitations of arithmetic bytes. 24 part-time employees can finish a bank-related project in 15 days. Okay. So for part-time employees, 24 of them can do it in 15 days. Okay. While 20 summer trainees can complete it in 20 days. Summer trainee days, 20 summer trainees, 12 days. So when we are looking at part-time employees, it is roughly 360 effective days. And for summer trainees, it is effectively 240 days. So I'm saying let the total work be 360, 240, 720 units. Total work be 720 units. Every part-time worker operates with an efficiency of 2. Every summer recruit operates with an efficiency of 3. Okay. A bank decides to employ 36 part-time employees and 16 summer trainees for the project. So the rate at which work is getting done is 120. Okay. So it takes 6 days. If the daily remuneration rates for each part-time employee and summer trainee are rupees 200 and 250 respectively, find the total remuneration bill for the entire project. Okay, so the daily bill will be 36 into 200 and 16 into 250. And then this whole thing will get multiplied by 6 to get the total bill. 36 into 200 is 7200. Okay. And 16 into 250, 4000. Or altogether, we get 11,200. And we need to multiply this by 6. So this will turn out to be 66,000 plus 1200. So 67,200. This will be the total bill that will need to be paid. Okay. Next. CP of an article is 80% more than that of B and 40% less than C. Okay. So CPs A, B, and C. A is 80% more than that of B. So I'm saying if CP of B was 5x, A will be 9x. And it is 40% less than C. So C will be 15x. The CPs I have identified. Next thing I have is SP of article A is 10% less than that of C. So SP of A is 9y, and for C it is 10y. SP of article A is 10% less than that of C. If profit on article A is 20% more than the profit on B, which we don't know right now, and 10% less than the loss on C, okay, so C has a loss. Profit on article A is 10% less than loss on C. 9y minus 9x is equal to 9 by 10 of 10y minus, sorry. It has a loss, no, it can't be 10y minus. So this, wait. It will be 15x minus 10y. Then we will have a loss here. Okay. So I will get 10y minus 10x is equal to 15x minus 10y. So 20y is equal to 25x, or x by y is equal to 4 by 5. So now I can take x as 4 So CP for A would be 36, for B it would be 20, for C it would be 60. And SP here would be 45 and 50. So profit or loss for A, B and C. A has a profit of 9 rupees. C has a loss of 10 rupees. We know that profit on article A is 20% more than the profit on B. So 1.2 times of the profit here is equal to 9. Sorry. If the profit here is P of 6 by 5 of P is equal to 9. So P is equal to 7.5. We know the profit for B is 7.5. What is the ratio of profit on article B to its CP? We've got 7.5 here. We've got 20 here. The ratio will be 3 by 8, therefore, option C. Next, Ram and Shyam invested some money at 7% and 8% per annum, respectively, at simple interest. At the end of 4 years, total interest received by them was 3020. Find the total money invested by both of them. If it is known that 9 times the investment of Shyam is equal to 11 times the investment of Ram. Let's see. We have been told 9 times investment of Shyam is equal to 11 times investment of Ram. So Shyam by Ram is 11 by 9 investment wise. So I will say Shyam has invested 11y, Ram has invested 9y. Okay. Ram and Shyam invested. Shyam has got 8%. So 11y into 8% for 4 years. So 32% directly. 32% plus 9y into 28%. All of this adds up to 3020. Yes, I can get a unique value of y now. Fun. Oh, I can also reduce this. This will become 8. This will become 25. This will become 25. This will become 7. So I get 88 plus 63. So 151. 1y is equal to 3020 into 25. This and this will get cancelled to give me 20. 20 into 25 will be 500. So y is equal to 500. Finally, we were asked total money invested. Total money invested is 20y. So 20 into 500 would be 10,000, which should be the answer in this case. Okay, next. An inlet tap can fill a tank completely in 36 minutes. But due to a leak in the bottom of the tank, it takes 48 minutes to fill the tank. A plumber tries to fix the leak, but he could only reduce its rate by 50%. To compensate for the leakage, the rate of the inlet pipe was increased by 25%. How much time will it take now to completely fill the tank? Okay. First thing I'm doing is I'm taking my tank size as LCM of this. So I'm saying tank size is 144. So rate for inlet is equal to 144 by 36 or 4. And rate of inlet plus outlet is equal to 3. So rate of outlet will be equal to minus 1. This is the initial state, but after my plumber's interaction, what all has happened? New rate of inlet has increased by 25%, so it has become 5. and rate of outlet, new rate of outlet, it has become, it has reduced by 50%, so it has become 0.5. So the final new rate, inlet plus outlet, will be equal to 4.5. So the time taken will be 144 by 4.5, which is equivalent to 288 by 9, which is equivalent to 32 minutes. So answer should be option D. Next, Ravi usually leaves home for college at 9 a.m. and reaches his college at 9:40 a.m., traveling by his bike at a uniform speed. One day, after covering 75% of the distance to college, he realized that he had forgotten an important assignment at home. He turned back, increased bike speed, collected the assignment, and reached the college at 10:05 a.m. that day. Time taken for turning back and collecting assignment from home is negligible. How much time in minutes would he take to cover the entire distance from college to home at the increased speed? Okay. Look at this. Let's say the journey from home to college was something like this. Each part was a kilometers or a meters in length. So Ravi usually leaves home at 9 a.m. and reaches college at 9:40 a.m. One day after covering 75% of the distance to college. So Ravi would have traveled three parts out of four. It would be here. And what would be the time then? Three-fourths of the time from 9 a.m. to 9:40. Three-fourths of the time would have gone. At 9:30 a.m. Ravi is here. So because he has to go back home, his journey would be something like this. He has gone this way and he has reached college. Here he would reach at 10:05 according to the question. So can you see Ravi has traveled 3A backwards and 4A forwards. He has traveled 7A parts in 35 minutes. At the increased speed, Ravi has traveled 7A units of distance in 35 minutes. Finally, we are only asked how much time would he take to cover the entire distance from college to home at an increased speed. Now, if he has to go from college to home at an increased speed, he has to travel 4A distance. If 7A distance was traveled in 35 minutes, 4A distance will be traveled in 20 minutes. And that is the entire solution to this question. That will be the end of this episode. Hopefully, you learned something. Okay, bye.